Democrat presidential nominee Joe Biden slams President Trump over national unrest, the coronavirus, and the economy. For fact check on his arguments, here's One America's Christina Howitson.
Cleveland, Ohio hosts the first presidential debate, with Democrat nominee Joe Biden trying to discredit President Trump's policies and the president himself. But while his arguments made use of mainly emotional appeals with direct addresses to viewers at home, a closer look shows that many that attempted to bring in evidence were just not true. On the economy, Biden accused the president of having failed in his work to secure stronger trade agreements for the U.S., specifically highlighting the U.S.'s relationship with China.
Take a look at what he's actually done. He's done very little. His trade deals are the same way. He talks about these great trade deals. You know, he talks about the art of the deal. China's perfected the art of the steal. We have a higher deficit with China now than we did before.
According to the Census Bureau, the trade deficit accounted for thus far in 2020 is not the highest the United States has ever seen. Through July, the deficit was $1.6 trillion. Under the Obama administration, during the same period of time in 2015, the trade deficit had already crossed $2 trillion, eventually hitting a record $3.67 trillion by the end of the year. The Democrat nominee also went on to claim the president's job-creating efforts would be for nothing, and Americans would face tougher unemployment after he left office than they saw before he took it.
The fact is that he has, in fact, worked on this in a way that he's going to be the first president of the United States to leave office, having fewer jobs in his administration than when he became president. Fewer jobs than when he became president. First one in American history.
Even if President Trump were to leave office in January, Biden's prediction cannot be reasonably made, as it improperly cites the Bureau of Labor Statistics' analysis of current unemployment. First, the Bureau of Labor Statistics, in its 2019 to 2020 job growth projection, said that due to the coronavirus, an accurate prediction could not be made. Secondly, even if such a prediction could be made, experts agree Biden is likely citing non-farm unemployment to make it, which excludes 20% of the workforce and is already beginning to recede back to pre-pandemic levels, dropping 5 points from April to August. Aside from fictitious numbers, Biden attempted to use the words of the president's advisors against him, and in doing so took former counselor to President Trump Kellyanne Conway out of context.
And by the way, you know, his own former spokesperson said, you know, riots and chaos and violence help his cause. That's what this is all about.
I don't know who said that.
I do.
Who?
I think Kellyanne Conway.
I don't think she said that.
She said that. And so here's the
all right.
But here's the point.
Go ahead.
The point is that that's what he is keeps trying to rile everything up. He doesn't want to calm things down. Instead of going in and talking to people and saying, let's get everybody together, figure out how to deal with this. What's he do? He just pours gasoline in the fire.
The comment Biden is attempting to cite came from a statement Conway made in August, where she said when people see, quote, chaos and anarchy and vandalism and violence reign, they want to choose the candidate who is better on public safety and law and order. A choice, she said, was, quote, very clear. Christina Howitson, One America News.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.